Fire has been a powerful part of the North American ecosystem for thousands of years, even before humans arrived.
Forests and fires have co-evolved for millions of years.
The first humans to interact with forest fires developed an understanding of how to use it and manage it.
Native Americans were burning the landscape for active land management. Fire would create a patchwork of young forests among old forests that actually survived the fire.
The arrival of European settlers changed this dynamic by disconnecting the land from its historic native managers and by misunderstanding how these forests functioned with fire.
Once we saw Euro-American settlement take hold and widespread alterations in the forest, where you had the high-grade logging and then the livestock grazing, kind of created these more dense forests than there were historically.
It seemed to be a lack of understanding about the value of fire. To some degree, I'd say a lack of tolerance, a fear. There was this natural tendency to put them out.
Once Native American fire use was removed, we started losing a lot of those natural fire cycles that cleared out, you know, a lot of the underbrush.
Now we have these overstocked forests that have a lot of fuel in them and they're ready to burn. And Mother Nature's making a correction.
We have introduced a man-made situation that basically contradicts the evolution of these forests.
With the increased development, more and more people using these public lands, that increase opportunities for human-caused fires.
We're putting infrastructure into these areas at a very rapid pace.
I can modify how houses are prone to ignition. I can modify how communities escape. What I can't change is the weather patterns. I can't change the extreme heat, and I can't change the wind.
Now you have these astronomical fuel loads that create firestorms.
The challenge that's put upon us is, are we fast enough to keep ahead of the curve?